Hey guys, whoa, it got kind of dark over there. That's pretty interesting. I think I like the dark blue tint over here. But anyway, so this video is really talking about the games I played this year in 2013. And I think 2013 was a pretty huge year for games. I followed some Game of the Year blogs here and there, and there have been many great discussions on games like, you know, BioShock Infinite, The Last of Us, Device 6, the new Professor Layton game, which I forgot the name of, Forza 5, Grand Theft Auto 5, Battlefield 4, Assassin's Creed 4, Gone Home, and so many other games that really deserve to be the talk of the industry. But I can't really speak much about games of 2013, and that's because while I know about all the games I mentioned there, you know, and BioShock Infinite, I watched an entire Let's Play of that game. While that's the case, I admit I haven't played any of them myself. I'm usually a really late adopter to games, so actually this year I've hardly played any game that was released in 2013. I think the only 2013 game I played this year were Tomb Raider, the reboot, and XCOM Enemy Within. So as such, if you ask me to make like a best of list, you know, best adventure game or best PS3 game of 2013 or anything like that, I'll just flat out tell you that I'm not qualified to do so and my list of that will be pretty shoddy. I would like to instead make a list that just consists of the games that I got to play this year, and point out which ones were my favorites. I think though that to many gaming enthusiasts, my list would actually be quite pitiful. My PS3 was in a broken state for most of the year this year, and I didn't have much money or time to spend on gaming. So ultimately what happened was that I ended up gaming a lot on my iPhone and on my iPad. Somehow, most of the games I played in 2013 happens to be mobile games. And yes, that's games like Real Racing 3, Temple Run 2, Badland, Pitfall, and such. The non-real games. I don't know. I also played a good deal of mobile ports. And I'm not qualified enough to say whether these iOS ports are better than, probably not, or even just live up to their console or handheld counterparts. But I quite enjoyed, actually, The Walking Dead, the first season, on my iPhone 4. Well, that game, I actually did play the first two episodes of it on my PS3 last year. And while the performance and the controls, I would say, were smoother with my DualShock 3, still, you know, it just happened to be that it's on my iOS devices that I played The Walking Dead on. The iOS port of the 500 Days DLC was released later on the App Store than on PSN or on Steam or whatever, but nonetheless, I got it for my iPhone when that came out. The other mobile ports I played in 2013 are Ghost Trick, Phantom Detective, and Ace Attorney, Phoenix Wright HD, which are the first three Phoenix Wright games all in one collection. It's pretty awesome, actually. Max Payne, Grand Theft Auto Vice City, Sonic Hedgehog 4 Episode 1, and most recently, Bastion. I think I definitely would have preferred to play some of those ports with the controller or with the mouse and keyboard, though. I mean, the iPhone version of Max Payne, for instance, I can't play on any of the higher difficulty settings. I can only play on the lowest difficulty setting. The touch controls work well enough, but when I crank up the difficulty, you know, it becomes like a twitch shooter because the AI responds so quickly and the amount of damage received gets so high, so that's pretty much impossible with touch controls. GTA Vice City and Sonic 4, I would say, were less hindered by touch controls, but I'm definitely a sticks and buttons type of gamer, like most gamers out there, so I think I would have preferred to play them using a controller. Still, Sonic 4 on the App Store, when I bought it, it was on sale. I got it for like $2.99, for $3, as opposed to its, you know, $15 price tag on other digital stores. The tighter controls of a DualShock 3 or even the Wii Remote controller just doesn't warrant the price hike for me. For games like Ghost Trick and Bastion, I would actually like to argue that the touch controls are the optimal way of experiencing these games. And I've actually played Ace Attorney, Phoenix Wright, Justice for All. I know it's a long name for a game. I played that on my Nintendo DS before, and that's actually my very first time I've experienced an Ace Attorney game. And after re-experiencing that game on my iPad, I'm gonna have to say I choose to cherish more the iOS version. On the iPad, Ace Attorney is prettier, smoother, and just overall more comfortable to me. Bastion has kind of some performance issues on my iPad too, but aside from that, Its auto-targeting system makes the iPad version fairly enjoyable to play with touch interface. Most of the games I played this year were just time wasters. There's really no story to be engrossed in with titles like Jetpack Joyride or Sonic Dash. The mobile space definitely is flooded with endless runners, you know, we often call them Temple Run knockoffs, you know, or Infinity Blade clones, there's a bunch of those, and definitely a lot of Farmville or Mafia-esque games. So for the immersive cinematic gameplay experience, and for a classic Nintendo experience like Super Mario 3D World, I would agree that for the most part, these mobile devices are sorely lacking, you're not going to get that. Still, I like to think of myself as much of a serious and hardcore gamer as anyone else, so, you know, I still think these mobile games are pretty damn good. And in 2013, that's not to say I only played mobile games, I played some non-mobile games as well. Somehow I ended up revisiting the first Splinter Cell game on my laptop, and I spent over 10 hours on it again. I checked out the awesome Half-Life 2 mod, Black Mesa, and finally experienced for myself the military strategy game, World in Conflict. I've been meaning to like play that for a long time, finally got to play it. And once I eventually got my PS3 fixed, I played a lot of Hitman Absolution and XCOM Enemy Within, and a lot of Call of Duty Black Ops 2. And I played some Wii games too, Xenoblade Chronicles, Okami, and all that. A lot of 3D games as well. So console and PC games, of course, still hold my interest. There's still nothing quite like those experiences. But somehow, this year, what I kept coming back to was to my iPhone and my iPad for gaming. I think it largely has to do with my lack of money and time, of course, more so than before I started being a graduate student. That and many mobile games these days aren't just anything to scoff off at either. Badland really is a unique experience that I think is best enjoyed on a smartphone or a tablet. And then there's Ridiculous Fishing, A Tale of Redemption, which is an indie masterpiece. Jetpack Joyride is free to play on phones and tablets as opposed to other platforms, and it's so awesome that I actually gladly pay for its reasonably priced in-app purchase items. Perhaps Rayman Fiesta Run is a bit too much like its prequel, Rayman Jungle Run, but that doesn't deny that it's probably the most enjoyment and fun I had with the game this year. Out of all the games I played this year, I think Rayman Fiesta Run was probably my favorite game, along with Ghost Trick and XCOM Enemy Within. But also Ridiculous Fishing, again, that game is so amazingly well done. Now, I think in 2014 I will play more console games and probably more PC games. I'll still most likely be a very late adopter to those games, but I don't know, I'm always impressed by the mobile gaming space. I'm not ashamed at all that most of the games I played in 2013 were in fact mobile games. Sure, none of them will probably be as deep, tight experiences as anything like The Last of Us or Forza 5. And a lot of these apps are tied down by time gates and other evils of microtransactions, at which point, you know, I got really frustrated at Real Racing 3 for, but I think it's beyond time that even these mobile games be recognized as games worthy of their own merits. So most of the games I played in 2013 were indeed mobile games. And, you know, I have to say, I had quite awesome time playing them.